coronavirus has impacted every facet of human life, and the food sector and dairy industry in particular is no different. What we've seen recently is that there was an initial big surge in retail demand for dairy products as more and more people heeded shelter-in-place orders and were eating more and more meals at home. There was more demand for dairy in the home, and so retail demand surged. At that same time, demand at food service declined steeply. So restaurants, hotels, schools, as those closed and shuttered, that demand decreased. Now, processing plants are equipped to make one type of dairy product usually, or a couple. So there, and a processing plant is where the dairy products, where milk goes from the farm, it goes to the plant to then be made into the dairy products that you buy and that you would see on your shelves. Now, many processing plants are specialized. So we might have a cheese plant that specializes in making 40-pound blocks of cheddar cheese that are designed to go into food service distribution. And we might find we have a processing plant that is designed to make fluid milk products. Those plants can't switch their infrastructure and all of their equipment to make a different product overnight. So as that food service demand has gone down, we see that there's less of a home for those products. And a lot of those products, like butter and cheese, have to be stored until there is demand for them. Now, we can only store so many dairy products. In many cases, products are being diverted to other plants as they have the capacity to do that. And at Dairy West, we're looking at how can we repackage and recut some of those larger items that are destined for food service for more of a retail environment. So as a very last resort, if there is no diverting that can happen, then dairy farmers are forced to discard of or dispose their milk, which is never a situation that we want to be in, to watch a high quality nutritious food be wasted. So another thing that's impacting demand is that exports, so typically we export about 15 to 20% of the dairy products that are produced in the United States. And as this virus has impacted the global economy, the demand for international exports has also gone down, which has increased the amount of milk that we have in the domestic market and further put a strain on this system.